us, SPF is something you're interested in. Sunscreen, you're here to apply, but you don't know what actually SPF is. You want to know the difference between SPF 30 or 50. Is a 100 even better? What kind of sunscreen are available? You totally got confused. What does it mean? And what to look on if you buy a sunscreen and which one is actually best for you? So if one of the questions is of interest of you, you should definitely stick with me. So hi guys, my name is Dr. Liv Kraemer, but everybody is calling me actually Dr. Liv. I'm here in beautiful Switzerland, actual beautiful Zurich. I'm a board certified dermatologist who doesn't know me, and I'm talking about all questions I get from my patients, from you, all the topic you're interested in, and I see that there are so many confusion all about, so I'm picking certain topics, and I would be delighted if you give me some suggestions down there in the comments. So this topic today, and by the way, subscribe to my YouTube channel, share to your friends, and now it's all about sunscreen, what to do, how to apply. So let's start. Okay, if we talk about protection, we have to do it very systematically. So let's talk about SPF. What does it mean? SPF means sun protection factor. Sun's actually cool, so I'm just protect against the sun, as is higher the number is better. Wrong. Because guess what? The numbers on a bottle of a sunscreen, this one, the number 30, 15, 50, 50 plus is just referring towards UVB protection. So now you're getting confused. It's like, okay, UVA, UVB, what's the difference? They're all the same. Oh no. So let's look at the sun. The sun is a high energy ray, right? Like the chemistry, in chemistry lesson, the Bunsen burner. So you need energy to get something quicker done. And the sun is our Bunsen burner, is the energy. So you have UVA and UVB. So UVB is a very low energy ray. It gets reflected by the window. So now inside here, I'm not getting a sunburn, I'm not getting a heavy cancer, and I'm not getting a tan, because UVB is not penetrating through the window. But because we're talking about beauty, we're talking about aging and anti-aging, guess, UVA is penetrating the window. So UVA is a very rich energy. It goes through the window deep into the skin and is smashing the cells. Exactly. And if the cells are smashed, you get pigmentations, rednesses, and wrinkles. So now you ask yourself, okay, but if the SPF, the number, is just referring to UVB, so it doesn't really matter. It has something to do with history. It did matter because we didn't want to get burned. So this is why we kind of choose numbers to have a referral thing. So, and the numbers, as I said, just referring to UVB. So you have to look on a special label with a UVA. Different countries, different laws. So here in Switzerland and in the European Union, we have the law that 1/3 of the actually number has to be a UVA protection. So, but in other countries it's different, so it's very important to look at labels. So not just about the number, but also about the label UVA with a round thing. Or in other countries about the PA++, so something what is protection or shows the protection against UVA. Remember, UVA, high energy, gets you the pigmentations, the rednesses, and the wrinkles. Okay, so now we said, okay, we have to look at the labels, we have to get to know that the number is just referring to UVB, but we want to make sure that we have an excellent protection factor, or excellent protection against UVA as well, so it has to be assigned there. Okay, fantastic. But now let's go to the numbers, which are very confusing for most of my patients, and I guess also for you. So the numbers, I have a patient who said, oh, I found an SPF 100, now I'm safe, that's the best. I just got a couple of bottles, now it's perfect. Wrong. You're never safe. So why I'm saying this is very easy. Let me show you something. It is not It's mathematic. It's about science, right? Beauty is science. And it's not about linear curves or as higher the number, as better protection we have. No, 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 no. It's an exponential curve. Now, mathematics, this is why you have to stay in school and learn mathematics. It's very important. So let me show you. I hope you can see it. So you have a kind of a curve. And an SPF 30 is protecting you against 97% of the UVB. But SPF 60, 98. So funny, right? It's not like double, it's all just 1%. So the difference between 30, SPF 30 and 50 is just lower than 1%. Interesting. Right? So we have to look at an SPF factor, at least with an SPF 30, because below it's a big difference, above 50, not really. So at least an SPF 30, more than SPF 50, 50 plus, doesn't really matter. So we also have to look at labels like UVA, because we want to protect our skin against pigmentations, redness, and wrinkles. So UVA is very important, so look at labels of UVA. And now it's a question about chemical and physical filters, which I get asked a lot, and people are confused and say, oh, I don't want to have chemistry on my face, I don't want to have chemical filters. Okay, guys, nature is physics and chemistry, chemistry is physics and nature. Really? Yeah, just don't look like these buzzwords. Think before you say something. So nature is physics and chemistry. Without chemistry and physics, nature wouldn't exist. So before you say something, think, right? So let's talk about physical and chemical filters to really let you know what we are talking about if we say about these, say something about these filters. So if you know my videos before about blackheads and whiteheads, you know that I love to draw, and all my patients of course know this. So you have the surface of the skin, which looks indeed like a cobblestone wall, mortar between the bricks, bricks between the mortar. So this is the top layer, this is the lower part. Physical filters are filters which are just on top. So you say, oh great, so they're just staying on top. Great, but you look totally whitish, because titanium dioxide and zinc dioxide are on the surface, which of course is great, but let's be practical. Most of you guys complaining, oh, it looks whitish, it doesn't look really great, particularly if you have a darker skin type, you really don't like it. So physical filters are great, but really not most of the time really practical, because they're whitish, because they're just reflectors. Of course, you can use tinted ones, which are a little bit better, which kind of having a kind of a skin color of your skin type. But let's go back to the physical filters. You have a high energy, the UV ray, and they're hitting these reflectors and getting reflected. This is how physical filters are working. Now let's talk about chemical filters. Chemical filters are filters who are in the mortar between the bricks. They don't go through, they stick here. So, and if you're a surfer, you know what I'm talking about, wave breakers, right? So think about your last beach kind of holiday. You don't like these heavy waves if you're not a surfer, you just like to bathe like me. So you're staying close to the beach, because before you have these heavy stones which reflecting the heavy waves into almost no waves where you can bathe and swim, right? So these wave breakers, they exactly the same as chemical filters. Why? Because you have a very energy ray which are very harmful, and these heavy rays are kind of hitting these particles and getting transferred in low energy heat waves, which are not harmful anymore for your skin. So ideally is having probably both on your sunscreen is a chemical filters and a physical filter in combination to have the perfect protection against UV rays. Okay, so now the question is, we know about chemical and physical filters. Now the question is, what sunscreen I have to apply? Give me some tips. Okay, so here are very useful tips. If you have the tendency of pimples, acne, redness, rosacea, never ever use creams. It's like, yeah, but it's sun cream. It's called sunscreen, but you have the possibility of the whole range from gel to heavy creams. So if you don't know what I mean, look at my video about serum creams, which I give you a kind of a thought what is the difference. But let's be practical. If it's very sticky, it's not the right thing for you. And believe me, there are a couple of range of sunscreen available, so look for gels, like instead of very greasy creams. So look rather also for a cream which is very light. You see it's always dropping and maybe has a little bit or is a little bit tinted, which is very easy to apply and doesn't has a greasiness. So I mean, you could go for a very sticky one and have really problems applying it because it's sticky and creamy. Why go on for creams if you can look for gels, light ones, without giving you the heaviness if you have the problems with pimples and acne? So another question I always get asked is about sprays. So sprays are actually not a good way. Why? Because you think I spray once and then I'm protected. Guys, it has to be 2 milligrams per square centimeter. So it's almost half a spoon. So look how often I have actually to pump, and this is not even enough for half of my face, right? So just spraying once, you never get the SPF factor which is on the bottle. So the SPF factors on the labels are just referring to an amount of sunscreen applying on your skin. So for example, a makeup with an SPF, so first of all, an SPF of 15 on a makeup is not enough. Secondly, there is no UVA protection side, so you're still aging. And you never apply this thickness of makeup that you're really getting the SPF factor, which is on the bottle of your makeup powder or makeup ground or whatever. So therefore, really make sure you wash your face. You put maybe a very light serum with antioxidants on side, not greasy, not oily, very light, if you have the tendency to pimples, acne, or rosacea. And then applying your sunscreen in a real amount. What does it mean? Really, if you really want to protect yourself, you have to apply 3, kind of almost 2 fingers for your whole face. Yes, it's a lot. So if you're putting it on, you really have to massage it in like a primer if you're using makeup, the same as you have to do with the sunscreen, really massaging it in really deeply. Look at my video, how to apply sunscreen. So let's summarize to get the confusion out now. So first of all, look at SPF factors, the numbers, at least 30 below doesn't really matter. 50 is totally enough. Everything above 50 is misleading. Look at labels like UVA or PAA plus plus plus, as higher as better, because you want to protect your face against the harmful UVA lights, which are giving you pigmentations, rednesses, and collagen loss, namely wrinkles. Try to apply a really good amount on your skin and do it after washing in the morning, after applying antioxidant serum. And if you have acne, pimples, or rosacea, then just a light serum and then a light sunscreen in a kind of a gel or lotion, not in a sticky cream. If you want to reapply sunscreen, of course it's great, but if you apply makeup, it's probably impossible to reapply. Then a spray might be a possibility, but it really doesn't give you the amount what it says on the bottle, because the amount you have to apply is really so much more than you think. You have to really pump almost 10 times and put it on to really get you the SPF protection which is on the bottle. Ideally, what I also like to show my patients are sticks, so SPF sticks 50. Some sticks are not whitish at all, but they're very fatty. But it's nice to apply it around the eyes during the day. Have this in your pocket and just reapplying it on the nose, on the cheeks, and maybe all around, also on top of the lips. But be very careful because these sticks are very sticky, very fatty. So if you're applying it somewhere where you have the tendency of acne, you are actually getting more pimples. So really maybe just stick around the eyes because these are the sun terraces. So this is where the sun is hitting and where you have to protect very intense your skin. I will talk another time about this. So I hope I get you a little bit an overview. I hope you like it. Give me a thumb up, subscribe to my YouTube channel, give me some comments about other topics you're interested in. Follow me on my Instagram story if I'm traveling around for conferences or for seeing people all over the world. Be my friend on Facebook, on Dr. Liv Kraemer. Love you all. See you the next. Bye-bye.